In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a 3D character of just about anyone. To do this, you are going to need a few things. First, the software that actually makes the character is called FaceGen. There are some other programs that will do this. I've tested like 4 or 5 over the years, but this is the one that I was actually happy with, the one that actually worked. Also, you need a 3D animation software that works with FaceGen. I'm working with Daz3D, but also Poser, iClone, Maya Autodesk, and a few others work great with this. You also need some kind of video editing program. It doesn't matter which, as long as that program can render a photo from video. It will be a big help if you have some kind of screen capture program. It doesn't really matter which, as long as it's high quality. And lastly, you'll need either After Effects or Photoshop. Even though you can get away with not having these, they are a huge help. Now, I know I just threw a lot at you. Most of these programs do cost money, but bounce that against, if you follow through with this, you will never have to buy a custom character ever again, and you'll never have to settle for using a character that you're not totally happy with. So the way FaceGen works is that you upload pictures into it, and it makes those pictures into usable characters. But in order for those pictures to work, they need to be very exact. You need 2 photos, with one of those photos being the person looking straight at the camera, and one with their head turned at a 90 degree angle. The lighting needs to be evenly spread, and the pictures need to be a similar resolution. And lastly, and most important, the person needs to have a totally blank expression. You can animate their face and give them different expressions later, but for this raw material, it has to be a totally blank expression. This is actually pretty easy if it's someone you know. You can just explain the pics you need and they can send them to you. Done deal. I really like turning my friends into 3D characters. I turned Jero into a Federation officer. I turned Martine into a Klingon. I turned Skiba into, well, Skiba. But if it's someone you can't just simply ask and they'll give these photos to you, you have to get creative. The first thing I did on this tutorial was to post this photo on Facebook and just ask people who they wanted me to make into a 3D character. And whoever got the most votes, that's who I would do. I figured this was a pretty solid test of my method. So Facebook has spoken, and the most votes was Robert Downey Jr. I know I shouldn't be that shocked, but I was, and this is the one that people wanted, so here goes. So this is the part where either Photoshop or After Effects is going to kick in. The reason I like After Effects for this application is that I can do kind of a 2-in-1. I found this scene from the Sherlock Holmes film, put it into screen capture, and now I've literally just got to go frame by frame, hopefully find the picture I want. And that's actually pretty good. Now, click on your scale here. Go Control-Shift-D. And that'll separate these two layers. Bring it back 1. Click right here. Right-click. Time. Freeze time. And now, this entire section is this photo. Now I gotta find the one for the side. There. Right click, time, freeze frame, bring it in. And press. Now this one actually looks pretty good. If you want to make it larger, push S for scale. Don't do it manually because you make the head too wide or too long or whatever. Bring it in. S, scale, and then R, rotate. If you have them kind of up like this,
It will make your life a great deal easier when you go to make them into usable photos. Now, the only problem with this type of lighting is, first of all, they're not 100% perfect. And there's way too much shadow in this shot. And this one also sucks. So go to Effects. And going to be Color Correction, Brightness and Contrast. Take the contrast all the way down. Bring the light a little bit up. Same here. Brightness, contrast, all the way down. And bring the brightness slightly up. And if you don't adjust their lighting to make them a little bit brighter, when you put this into your 3D program, the faces for some reason are going to turn really purple. I have no idea why.
So now that I have all my raw materials, it's time to actually incorporate face gen. I'm going to do this guy as a G3, male, and I'm going to call it Robert Downey Jr. 3. Go up here to Create. Load image. This is the forward image. Can you tell I make a lot of these? To the side image. Next. Now, because looking directly into the camera is a cardinal sin of filmmaking, even though his face is going forward, his eyes never are. So you have to kind of guesstimate where the widest part of the eyeball is, and that's how you find the center. And click. And about there. Now, the nose is easily what face gen screws up the most, and it's also what will make your character not look like the person you want. You will see that you have a really nice centering on the curve of the nose. Really take your time on this part. Corner of the mouth, corner of the mouth, right where the edge of the mouth is. It's pretty easy. Center chin. Now, to establish the lower jaw, it goes straight across and then slightly down. To establish the cheekbone, go straight across from where you click the eye and then significantly down. Now back to the nose. He's got a pretty significant convex to his nose. And like I said, the nose is, for some reason, this is just what FaceGen screws up. So be very careful to click here, establish the corner of the eye. Now this is actually one of the updates that I really like. It allows a center digit on the nose. But here's the thing, see how the directions say I should put it right in the base of the farthest tip, which should be right about here. This is wrong. For some reason, FaceGen wants to give your characters a pig nose. I have no idea why. For some reason, you gotta put it significantly lower, right about here, actually. And then this corner right here is to establish. It's perfectly fine. You want to go to the top of the lip, bottom of the lip. This will establish mouth and lip size. Protruding chin and jawbone. Create. So, actually less than a minute of exporting time, it gives me this forward face. Now you probably noticed something else. Look at that. Totally flat aquiline nose as opposed to a heavy convex. I told you they always get it wrong. This is probably a good time for me to explain that FaceGen is not exactly magic. So we have the modify icon right next to create. Go all the way down and then kind of make tiny little changes And every time you do something that you don't like, go to undo under the edit menu. Probably good as gonna get. Then go to file, I already named it. Scroll all the way down and then export. So now that I've got my character fully exported, I've got a little bit of a convex to his nose, which will actually be more defined when I actually import the character for some reason. But this down here is where you're going to find the textures, and this is important if you actually want to apply the textures and you desperately want to apply the textures to the character when you want to use it. Goes users, public, documents, my Dash3D library, runtime, textures, face gen, Genesis 3, and the name. I do this so much, I can pretty much find this location in my sleep. So this is Dash3D in case you've never used it before. I highly recommend this for beginners. Even if you move on to more advanced software, then this is still a good place to build your characters. I have my generic G3 guy all pulled up. Click on his head. Go to shaping. All. Got my shape all set up. Obviously, you turn it to 100. Doesn't really do much of anything, does it? Although the nose does look better. So now I have to go to surfaces, click on them, click on this little carrot, defaults, template 1. That's going to be his face. Go down to here to diffuse color, click on it, browse. Come over here to your C drive, users, public, public documents, my Dash3D library, runtime, textures, face gen. And like I said, this is exactly this route right here. G3 male. Yeah, that's a little bit more recognizable, isn't it? And nose isn't quite as deep a swoop as I was hoping, but it's passable. And then you have your corresponding textures. Just make sure that this picture... Hold on. So I'm just going to apply the rest of his textures. Go to template 2, diffuse color, browse, users, public, public documents, my Dash3D library, runtime, textures, face gen. And yes, I do have shortcuts right here, but this is a tutorial, so you gotta learn, right? So remember, make sure this matches this. And that is how you do this. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to comment. If you want to help me out, please subscribe.